What is your setup for doing your videos when you're recording these or doing your like tablet drawing, or when you're narrating, or when you're sitting at your chair that you have? There's a chair that you sit in. Like, how are you recording those? What's your setup?
Yeah, I've been sort of experimenting each time a little, doing something a little differently every time, just to see what works best and feels best. You know, I thought that doing things analog style, like traditional media, with like messy ink and stuff dripping down, would be like more on brand, and I enjoy that probably more anyway. But that's really hard to shoot.
Yeah.
And what I've found so far is it's really hard to like have a camera on me and the right lighting for me and properly light a piece of paper on my desk that's a foot and a half away from my face, mm-hmm. where that's going to show up. And then it's not going in and out of focus every time I put my hand in there.
Oh yeah.
It's really hard to get all set up. And so that's ended up with me like nudging things around and moving tripods and lights for like 2 hours in order to record a live video every time. So it's all set up in my bedroom right now, our bedroom. So I don't know if I can turn the camera. You'll see like there's my bed.
Oh,
a bunch of lights that I ended up not using. So I'm just in this like one third of my bedroom, where I can have a little bit of space. And it's when I have all the tripods and the lights, I end up having to climb over the bed back and forth in order to adjust things. And it's pretty ridiculous. So we're setting up we're going to build a studio out of our garage this year.
Oh, cool.
So that'll help. You can keep everything set up and ready to go. And you can just go sit down and turn everything on. Right now, there's a lot of setup time every time I want to record. Mm-hmm. But that said, I love going live, and I really like, somebody said, oh, you should do this on Twitch, like when I first started.
Right.
And I was like, I don't think I can draw and talk at the same time. So for the first 6 months, it was faked. It was me drawing. I'd record it from overhead or whatever, or digitally. And then I would record a story, or maybe I would record myself in front of the camera telling the story, and then I would intercut those things to make it look like I was drawing and talking. And that's just so much editing. It was like 4 days of editing for a 4-minute video. So that was not sustainable. But now if I set up to do live, I love OBS. I'm really kind of used to that setup. I kind of, you know, grew into that whole live internet video early on, like in the 90s. I had a job that was doing similar stuff. Hmm. They were developing similar stuff. It was very instantly intuitive for me. I've done live shows drawing for like comedy called Picture This, where the comedian would talk and then you would draw either what they're talking about, or you kind of roast them and draw stuff to mess with them. And there was this whole back and forth, and it was for a live audience. And people loved that in San Francisco. It was always a big hit. It was actually out of LA, but we were like the San Francisco branch. And I loved that. And it was weird that like I was in charge of roping in other artists to you know, draw with me. We'd have to have like a set of, you know, 4 or 5 artists to go through the whole lineup. And most people would say no. And then even like a lot of the artists that did a great job who are like my friends, and I was like, oh man, you did a great job. People loved what you did. And this one guy was like, I am never doing that again. He just hated the pressure of it. So that always blew me away, because I think I thrive on that, you know. I don't mind going up on stage and like doing open mics and bombing. I would rather get laughs, but there's some like adrenaline surge either way. Even if you bomb, you still get that adrenaline surge. So mm-hmm. I don't mind it as much. And the worse you drew with that, the better a show you would have, because people liked the stupid looking drawings, you know?
Yeah.
So I'm kind of doing my version of that now with these lives. And that's, you know, just as much setup, but then you do it and it's done. And you just put out, last time it was 2 hours and 40 minutes. I lose track of time. Mm-hmm. I only stopped because I realized my ass had fallen asleep. So I like that more. I want to keep doing that. I want to get it so that it goes to YouTube and Twitch. And I might even, like, it sounds like a lot of people on Twitch will do like an edited version once they're done. Mm-hmm. They'll make like a 3-minute version of what happened. So I'd like to do that if I have the bandwidth.
Yeah. Well, there's also the thing too, where what I've seen, or at least what I've done in the past, is stream it to Twitch, and then Twitch lets you export it to YouTube as a private video, and then you can use the editor in YouTube to cut the video, so you don't have to do the
You never
whole,
have to download it.
yeah, you don't have to download it, you don't have to do the whole, okay, now I have to wait for my file to render. You just edit it directly in YouTube, and then when it's done, publish it, and you have your like different highlights that you can create, or you can create highlights on Twitch from your reel and then export those highlights to YouTube. You know, it's one of those things, but you can't do your intros and all that kind of stuff. You have no like loading card unless you actually put it in the live stream itself. But so there's that. But yeah, it's a different sort of, and it can go for either way. And I agree with you, like doing the live streams, it's kind of like, okay, that went fine. Like for some reason, I'll be like, oh, and this is what happened, and I'm going to do it this way. It's like you're directing, knowing that you can't go back and edit it. Whereas when I set up to record something, I feel like it takes forever. I don't like the way it looks. I feel like, okay, I'll just do that again because or I'll fix that in post. Whereas when you're doing it live, it's like, nope, you got to figure out how are you gonna get yourself out of this one? You know? And that's exactly what you were saying. You're like, you were going, yeah, because then you got to think one step ahead of yourself rather than like, oh, what are people gonna think of this? Is this gonna be any good? It's like, nope, you're live now.
There was I heard that Bob Barker on the Price is Right, I heard that he would do something similar where he would mentally edit while he filmed. He had like a sense, or he watched the clock somehow, and he keeps things moving so that he could show up, record the show. It took an hour and he was done. Where if he had the mindset that, oh, we're going to edit this later, it would just drag out forever, and it would mean like hanging out afterwards and making sure that things get edited correctly and everything. So if you just mentally edit and keep in mind what I can do on camera right now, that's going to be okay, then you're done. So I like that better.